do the one finished if you want. Because it's lashing outside. It's probably snowing or something.
Redirecting to Facebook Live. Here we go.
You want me to go my at the live?
Yes, please. Good afternoon, everybody. We are now live on Facebook this afternoon with myself and Simon. But I'm giggling because our screens are showing something different to what you're possibly seeing. And he's coming back again. Lauren wants to know, is everything okay? Jenny is actually logged in. Jenny, you said you weren't tuning in this afternoon. And I was very upset when I saw that because I desperately, desperately wanted to chat to you today.
Well, it's nice to have you on board anyway, Jenny. So I hope you're feeling good. So.
Yes, hope you're feeling okay. So listen, we're going to just hold on a wee second to everybody at our bases. Gets logged on. We're keeping an eye here on the numbers. Lauren, is things okay? We'll just start by saying yes, things are okay, and I am not coming on today with bad news, so please don't be worried about what's going to be said.
Emma Baird just joined us. Just hello, Linda and Simon. How's things with you both?
We're good. Yes, happy new year to everybody. Happy new year, everybody. I hope everyone had a lovely Christmas, and I hope Santa came and brought lots of nice goodies. Certainly some of these have been shown. Tori saying we are here.
Hello,
yes.
Hello.
And Colin was showing me his very, very posh.
Yes, he showed me his earbuds as well.
Earpods, whatever you want to call them, AirPods.
Can everybody hear us out there okay, by the way? We're just sitting talking away here. I'm not really sure if everybody can hear us. If you can hear us, just say a big yes. You can still hear us. I'm very certain
that we're happy new year. Hello, Anne-Marie. Happy New Year. Jenny was in isolation, yes, and hopefully you were happy with the news that you got, Jenny. I'm hoping that was good news that you got. Okay.
So we have 9 people. Oh, Linda, I nearly had a heart attack. Christmas. Okay. Yeah, everybody can hear us. Okay, Lauren said. Yeah, good.
Thank you, Lauren.
That's good to know because we're sitting here talking away ourselves and not realizing everybody can't hear us. But yes, yeah. Everyone set up. We're all running away. We're all doing good. So I'm glad you all had a good Christmas and a really good New Year. I had a really good Christmas. Santa didn't come to me because I'm a bad boy, but he came to the kids. That's the main thing. Did Santa come to you, Linda?
He did, yes.
There we go. Linda must be a good girl as well. So we got 14. Whoa, we just jumped from 6 to 14 there. So 50 people have started to join in now. We'll just wait till we get some people on from Korean base and Ballymena base as well, because they said they were joining as well. There, Laura Cairns just
jumped
in.
Hello from Ballymena base. Hello, Ballymena base.
Hello, Ballymena base. We're just waiting on Korean as always. Come on, where are you, Korean base? Get logged on and then we'll start this wee chat we got going. 19 people are watching us now.
Excellent.
So I suppose when we're waiting, we can register a new member of staff today.
Yes, that would be a good idea. Just when we're getting everybody logged on, we're going to introduce you now to our newest member of the team.
Give up my seat for a minute and introduce you to our new member of staff. There we go. On you go.
Your life, so the time lapse. So this is Natasha, and she'll tell you who she is now in a wee minute. I'll just say hello, Ben. Hello, Andrew. Have just popped on. So Natasha, do you want to tell everybody who you are?
I am Natasha, and I am a digital media assistant for at least 6 months.
Yes, Natasha's on the Job Start program. So the bases will know that Korean base now has Jonathan. Ballymoney base will have Jordan from next week. So yes, we have Natasha who will be helping Simon with CAN TV, with the website, with Facebook, with YouTube, with all our digital media, all our social media. So she will be in touch with you all to chat about what we need to do to make it all better. All right. Hello, Megan. the two Megans, Megana and Megan, are both on. We have Megan and Megana on now this afternoon.
Megana, how are you, Megan? Hello, Megan Work as well. Hi, Simon and Linda. Megan Work said as well.
And Tristan. Yes, and Tristan has joined us. So we've 23. So listen, I think I am ready to make the big announcement, Simon.
I think we are.
The big announcement everybody's been waiting on. The big announcement is that we are keeping the base open. Okay, so I'm saying it again, the base is not closing, all right? We have changed our COVID surge strategy, which just means our COVID plan, and we will be keeping our bases open. We have made some changes in Ballymoney base so that the staff are now in bubbles, the same as you're in bubbles. So when you're at base, you're in your bubble. And it means there'll be no new people joining in your day, or there'll be no change in the days or anything like that. You're now in your base bubble and the staff are now in their bubble. Okay, so we have a base staff bubble and then we will have the project staff bubble.
That's us.
Okay, the idea with that is that then if one of our staff in the base has to isolate or becomes ill with COVID, we have other staff then on the projects who can cover. So we think that's the best way of keeping the base open, but keeping everybody safe. So both you guys and the staff, okay? So that's the plan. Now, what that means for all of you coming to base is that we have to be really strict with the rules. So we have to remember social distance, washing your hands, using your temperature check machine at the door, signing in, making your declaration to say that you don't have any COVID symptoms. And we also need you to be really, really good and tell us when you don't feel well. Tell us if you're a contact. So tell us if somebody in your family has COVID or test positive or is isolating. Just keep us up to date. We will advise you every day if there's anything you need to do to change, okay? We want to keep the base open. We are not planning on closing. And yes, Lauren, there is still a 2 meter rule in place. Now, it's slightly different for Simon and I here just at the moment because we're not facing each other. The rule is slightly different if you're face on or back to back. So we're okay at the moment as we are not looking at each other. Okay, so we're not classed as close contact. All right. So that's the big bit of news. That's the happy news. We are keeping the base open. We do not plan to close it at this point in time. All right. Second bit of news then is around the new mask rules. And I'm sure you have been reading in the press and reading on Facebook that, did you read it, Simon, originally, that you now had to prove if you didn't wear a mask?
I did. I was kind of confused by what was going on. There were so many conflicting stories and stuff. So.
Yeah, well, they had said that they were going to have a new rule. This was Stormont had said there would be a new rule from next Monday. It came in December and then they delayed it till next Monday. And that if you didn't wear a mask, you had to prove that you were exempt. And this caused a lot of confusion and a lot of anxiety and worry for people, because how do you prove that you're exempt from wearing a mask? How do you prove that you have a learning disability, for example, or autism? And I know some of you had spoke to a doctor and the doctor had said, no, I am not giving you a letter say you don't have to wear a mask. And people were very, very worried. Janet then did the piece with the BBC about it. And again, we've had lots of new people be in contact with us about it. Last night then we got a letter just to give us some more information. So I'll read you the letter. I put it on our Facebook page, but some of you maybe didn't read it. So I'll read it to you and then Simon, you can maybe start seeing if there's questions about that.
Yep.
Okay, so it says, Dear Speaker, the letter's addressed to Alex Maskey, who is the Speaker of the House at Stormont. And it says, Dear Speaker, further to our statement on the 22nd of December, we are writing to provide you and MLAs with an update on the issue of exemption from wearing a face covering. Okay, so plain English, that is, in follow-up to the information we put out on the 22nd of December, we're writing to you with an update. Okay. As the Assembly was previously advised, the Executive decided on the 22nd of December to remove the exemption from wearing a face covering on the grounds that it causes severe stress, and to place on the individual the onus of providing an exemption on medical grounds. A grace period until the 7th of January before enforcement is implemented was also agreed. So that just means on the 22nd of December, they were saying if you didn't wear a face covering, you had to prove that you had a medical reason to not wear one, and that it causing severe stress wasn't a medical reason. Okay. In light of the need to give further detailed consideration to the logistical issues involved in obtaining proof of exemption, the Executive has now also decided to extend the grace period to a date to be further determined and to remit the Executive's COVID task force to undertake further meetings with stakeholders. Okay, plain English that. Yeah. It means that they realised that they could not police, they could not check if people had proof of exemption. It also means they recognised that people maybe couldn't get exemption or proof of exemption. So they have decided to extend the grace period. Okay, so it means the rule will not happen. And that will be a date to be further determined. So in other words, they don't know. Okay, so it's just it's going to be extended. And at this stage, there is no date. And they will undertake meetings with stakeholders. That means they will ask people like you what you think. Yep. Okay, so they'll speak to staff. They'll speak to
yourselves.
They'll speak to families. They'll speak to shops and businesses and whatnot, and they'll find out what they say. This matter will be discussed again at the Executive meeting on the 6th of January.
Which is today.
So there may be further information this afternoon. And a copy of the letter has been sent to all MLAs and chair of the committee. And that was signed by Paul Given and Michelle O'Neill, who are the first deputy first ministers.
We have questions. Ben McAllister says the news is saying they're cutting isolation from 10 days to seven. Well, must be 7 days.
Seven days. Yes. Again, we'll get on to that in a wee second, Ben, around and the new rules for isolation.
Emma Baird says, I was angry yesterday after finding out we have to wear a mask at all times in base. Emma, the reason we're making you do it all times in base is so we can keep base open.
Yeah.
We have to do our best to try and stop cross-contamination and cross-infection. And wearing a mask all day means that we can at least eliminate that sort of thing and keep base open for that wee bit longer. If you don't wear masks, it's inevitable that eventually we would have to probably think about kind of limiting numbers or shutting something down, because that's what the mask is there for.
That's right. If it is causing you distress, if there is a medical reason, if there is a reason that you cannot wear your mask, please talk to the staff at base. And talk to your day ops, and we can look at it. But we, at this stage, we are encouraging everybody who can wear a mask, who can tolerate it, to wear their mask as much as possible. Now, I know it's horrible. I know, and especially for us girls, we can't put our makeup on, and nobody sees our lovely lipstick that Santa brought, and all these things. But it is about safety. It's about keeping each other safe. It's about keeping our services open. So whether we really like it or not is something that we have got to do.
I don't particularly enjoy wearing masks either. They fairly make my glasses steam up all the time and they fall off my nose. But if it's a sacrifice I have to do to keep our services open and stuff, then I'm more willing to do it.
That's right. And we can help you find the mask that works for you.
Oh, because there's lots of different masks out there.
Lots of different.
Yeah.
I mean, I have on a disposable mask, but mine's a particular type that doesn't steam my glasses as much. Simon's is neoprene. So everybody finds a different type.
I've seen a really nice mask that was advertised the other day. It's got built-in headphones, straps around the back of your head, and it's got two glowy LED things in the front.
Oh!
I was thinking of buying that just to show off. I have my techno mask.
You'd be like a cyborg coming in, Simon.
Robo-Simon.
Yes, Robo-Simon.
Meg Anderson says, I have to wear my mask all day at tech, and it's not very much fun. It's not fun having to wear a mask. Nobody enjoys wearing them, Megan, but if it's a wee thing we have to do to keep things open, then so be it. That's just how it goes.
Yeah. And people are frustrated. We appreciate people are frustrated, but we have to do everything we can to keep you guys safe and to keep the staff safe so that we can keep the service open. None of us wants to get, you know, to where we were 2 years ago or even a year ago, even this time last year when we had to close things down again. So we want to keep everything open.
We do.
So I'm just going to run over the news, because again, there was new rules yesterday about isolation, which is what Ben is asking about, and also around testing. Okay. So the first thing I suppose is, Simon, lateral flow testing.
Yes.
Explain it and really
how you have to do it.
Well, what's the lateral flow test?
A lateral flow test is, we've all done it, is one where you get the big long swab and you have to stick it around the back of your throat.
Yeah.
And then you stick it up your nose and you put it in the solution and you drip it onto the card or the wee plastic tab thing, I suppose you could call it. And if it comes up C, then you're clear. Some people think if it comes up C, you've got COVID, but that's not what it means. If it comes up C, then you're clear of all infections. Or if it comes up, those are two lines, comes up, one at T and one at C, then you have an infection.
Yeah.
Basically, now they've changed the rules to lateral flow. If you do a lateral flow and you test positive with a lateral flow, then you isolate. You go straight and isolate. It used to be you had to, if you had
PCR,
get a PCR. You only get a PCR symptom or test now if you do a lateral flow and it proves that you're positive and you have symptoms.
And you have symptoms. So
go ahead.
I was just going to say there are wee flow charts that have appeared out from NI Direct and from the COVID-19 site and stuff like that.
I'll post those links up at the bottom of this when we finish on the video. I'll make sure the links are on the page so you can get
all right. And I'll just take you through it. So as Simon said, a lateral flow is the test you do at home. The PCR is the test that you go to a test centre and have done.
You do.
Okay. Although you may still do it yourself, you go to a test centre to have it done. So if you have no COVID symptoms, okay, so if you don't have the dry cough or the temperature or any of the COVID symptoms that you're all very familiar, the taste, the smell, all those things, then you take your lateral flow test twice a week. And also before you would go to do an activity. So if you were going out to do an activity, you would take your lateral flow. If you were going, for example, to visit with family, particularly if there was somebody that was maybe a wee bit more vulnerable, you would do a lateral flow test, all right? If your lateral flow test comes up positive, so if the wee line's at the T on your lateral flow test, you need to then self-isolate for 10 days, okay, from the day after you took the test.
So it's the day after
the day after,
yes. So if you took your test today, your isolation period would start from tomorrow.
Okay.
10 days from tomorrow.
And Lauren's saying, yes, she has to do it twice a week. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody should be lateral flowing twice a week.
As Ben says there, one line means negative and two lines means test positive. That's right.
Correct. A bit like a pregnancy test.
Well, I wouldn't know. I've never done one.
My husband will be delighted that all of mine are negative, pregnancy, lateral flow and all the rest. Okay, so we do that. You then can stop isolating from day 7, which is where Ben was asking, has it gone from 10 days to 7? All right, so they're saying you isolate for 10 days. However, you can stop isolating after 7 days if you have two negative lateral flow tests taken 24 hours apart.
Yeah.
So you should test then on day 6 and day 7.
Mm-hmm.
And if you then are having two flow tests, lateral flow tests that are negative, do another one and that's you then out of isolation for day 7.
Jenny Lindsay has just asked, how do you do things if you just have a common cold or chest infection? Can I still go to base or not? If you do a lateral flow, if you have any symptoms at all and it comes up negative, then by all means, you can come on into base. That's not a problem. We still understand there's still things like the cold and flu's all out there.
Yeah.
That's just human nature is how things go. But if you do a test and you do prove positive, then please don't come into base.
Yeah. And the other thing is, it's like the staff and I were discussing this on Zoom the other morning. You know, be sensible here. Because we don't want you spreading the cold or the flu or a tummy bug or whatever among your peers. So that is no difference, you know, from any other years. Just because you might not have COVID doesn't mean you should come in if you're unwell.
Exactly.
If you're unwell, you don't come in. Okay. You stay at home.
Megan Anderson says she's killing herself at what you said, Linda.
Well, about me being pregnant.
Your pregnancy test.
Yes, me and my pregnancy test. Yes, it would be a medical miracle.
Megana finds that.
Okay, now that's your lateral flow if you have no symptoms to start with, but you get a positive test. If you have COVID symptoms, all right, so if you have the temperature, the dry cough, or the loss of taste or smell, and also just want to throw in here, Simon, the new symptoms with Omicron.
Is that where you get upset stomach and the vomiting and stuff?
You can, yeah. You can have an upset tummy. You can also have a very scratchy throat. And you can have a very bad headache. Mm-hmm. Some people have said about issues with their eyes and night sweats.
Yeah.
Okay, so those are additional symptoms. So if you would have them, then you do book a PCR test.
You do.
Okay.
Lauren says, I do not understand. I thought it was self-isolating for 7 days, not 10 days.
No, it's 10, because they have, it normally was 7 days, Lauren, with a PCR test. Mm-hmm. But because they've run out of PCR tests, or they're running out of PCR tests, and we've gone now to lateral flow, they're saying with lateral flow positive, it's a 10-day isolation.
10 days. Which is lucky, because when I got COVID 2 years ago, I was 14 days.
That's 14 days
with me and Netflix. That wasn't fun.
No, and that's the difference. And it's because of the time that the two tests catch the virus.
Yeah.
All right. The lateral flow is known as a rapid antigen test, and it kind of picks up when it's earlier in your body. Mm-hmm. The PCR then confirms it when it's been in your body a little bit more. Okay. So the other thing then is close contacts, because we had a discussion yesterday around, well, what do you do now if you're a contact? Because the rule before was you took a PCR test on day 2 and day 8. Mm-hmm. And now they're saying, no, that's not what you do anymore,
they
Simon.
That now,
that's been changed now, Simon. So, Simon, if you are a close contact,
okay,
you go home this evening and Trish says, Simon, I've tested positive for COVID.
God forbid, but yeah.
Okay. You have to self-isolate until you do your lateral flow test.
Okay.
And then you have to self-isolate, or you have to take a lateral flow test every day for 10 days.
So I would go home tonight and Trish would say I'm positive, then I have to isolate until I take a lateral flow test.
Yes, until so you do the test.
I take one straight away and it comes back negative, then I am fine, but I do one for the next 10 days.
10 days.
That's okay.
The next 10 days. Now that is only because I know you're vaccinated.
Ah, okay, yes.
All right.
Okay.
So that is if you are fully vaccinated,
okay,
you then just have to do a lateral flow test for 10 days.
Okay.
All right.
Does it say what you do if you're not vaccinated, no?
Yes, it does. If you are not vaccinated, you have to isolate for 10 days and book your PCR test if you develop symptoms.
And that's only if you're not vaccinated. Yeah. Now. Okay. Yeah.
So if you're not vaccinated, you have to isolate for the 10 days and then if you develop the symptoms, then you book your PCR, but you don't book your PCR until you develop the symptoms.
So you get your symptoms first before you go to the next stage.
The key difference there is if you're vaccinated, you don't have to isolate. You do your lateral flow for 10 days.
Okay.
If you're not vaccinated, you must isolate for 10 days.
Okay, so there you go. So you've heard it here. Linda's
okay. All right. So again, we will...
They'll post the links up at the end of this video where I'll put them out separately or something. We'll put the links up so you can find
these. Put these up, okay. Ben's asking the taste bugs. Yes, your taste bugs.
Your taste bugs go. And I tell you, Ben, that is one of the most horrible things ever. If you ever try to eat food when you can't taste it, it's soul destroying. It's terrible. It's one of the worst things about COVID.
And how long did that last?
Oh my goodness. My COVID came at Christmas last year, or I'm sorry, 2020. And I didn't get my taste back properly till about April time.
Really?
So 3-4 months was that.
So again, you would say it's worthwhile wearing your mask.
Oh, yes.
To protect your taste buds because, you know, it's nice to be able to, as you say, taste what you eat.
Well, when you look at me, I like my food. The worst thing about it was eating food that you knew was lovely, but you couldn't taste it. And it actually alters your taste as well, because things, even when my taste bugs come back again, weren't just the same as what they've been before.
No.
So there you go. So
some people report it too, that they suddenly liked a taste that they've never liked before.
I have found that kind of a wee bit too. There's certain things I wouldn't eat before that I'm more tolerant with my eye. Yeah, so maybe it's a good thing.
Interesting.
But anyway, masks stop all that sort of stuff.
Yeah, so Megan's saying she was happy to see Granny and Grandma on Christmas Day, and I think that was very important for lots of people, and I think that's why we've taken the decision, Simon, you know, as a team. We sat on Monday we took that decision, and I think it's important that people see their friends, and I think it's very important for people's mental health.
Nobody wants to be locked in the house 7 days a week or whatever. Everyone wants to get out and see people and meet people. That's just what we like to do.
Yeah.
And we will try our best as much as we can. But, as long, but you guys have to help us to do this as well. We can't do this by ourselves.
That's it.
You just have to help us too. So
That is it. We are awaiting information from the Trust around helping you with your lateral flow test. And once I get that information, I'll give it to you. But at the minute, we don't have anything further on that. A wee bit then on other projects. What's going to happen to the other projects? Cody's off this week, so we don't really want to...
No, we don't need to talk about what Best Buddies are going to do. Best Buddies will probably put their heads together on Monday and then we'll come back to you then with what's happening then. So
It is likely that, again, the big sort of events with big numbers, a bit like Christmas, will have to go on hold for now. But, you know, Best Buddies operates with a completely different working format than the BS. So, you know, it may be that we can still do that quite safely.
Do small events.
Small events, small, Simon. Small, a bit like the meetups and many, stuff. Maybe. Yeah.
As I say, we don't want to put words in Cody's mouth. I'll wait to see what you think. So.
And I mean, we are planning the same with Hub. We will break the group into two so that Hub can keep going. It's about how we take the service or the project and how we change it and how we adapt it so that we can keep going face to face as long as possible.
Yeah, that's the goal. They stay.
That's open. It.
Well, it is. I'm just reading through our things. Emma said, I was happy to see my granny and oldest brother and sister and my nephew. Yeah, I'm sure you were. Everybody likes to see family. So they do. And Anne-Marie Watts. Hi, Anne-Marie. Glad to see you on there. Said mental health's not a nice thing. No, it's not. And it's good to get out and about and meet people. Keep yourself fresh and happy, and meeting people is a good thing for you to do. I've been stuck in the house all the time. And I think that seems to have covered everything.
That's us, yeah. That's all certainly all the information and the news that we had. And just to be very, very clear, we are not closing the bases.
No, not closing down.
Okay.
But before we come on here, Linda had told me she had one thing she really wanted to do. Linda wants to read the weather.
I want to do the weather. So hopefully we'll get that set up and I can do the weather a day on CAN TV. That would be really cool.
Do you think Linda should do the weather? Do you think we should have sort of CAN TV news? We could do something every week where we could have CAN TV news. We could have different weather reports. We could have a guest weather report every week. How about that? These are all things we're looking forward to. If you have any ideas for CAN TV or whatever, put them in the comment section here, or you know where you can get me on Messenger anytime. Let us know your ideas and we'll see what we can do.
Yeah, because we have talked, Simon, haven't we, about having almost like a current affairs program that the guys would
because I know at the minute it's tough because COVID has shut a lot of things down again, because I just heard today apparently it's especially needs bowling and stuff,
especially Olympics and
this has been shut down. But you guys do lots of things, and if you want to tell us all about them, we'd love to hear, and we can put stuff out and let other people know about it in CAN TV as well. It'd be great.
Yeah, look, they want me to do the weather forecast.
You're popular. There you go. You could be a weather girl.
So I could be the new Barra Bears.
Have to shave your head, give you a baby, but I'll work something to get.
Oh my goodness.
So anyway, guys, I think that's probably us done for
today.
So anyway, before we go, just again, man, if you can, keep these masks on at all times. They just keep that wee bit more safer than not wearing one. Remember your social distancing. Try and stay at least 2 meters apart if it's possible. It's not always possible, we understand, but try and keep as far away as you possibly can. But what's more important than anything else is washing these hands. You have to wash your hands regularly. Use soap, hot soap and water, or hand sanitizer, whatever you got, but keep them nice and clean. Hands, face and space. That's the message. Says Lorna Khan says, thank you from Ballymena Base. Good to have you on board, Ballymena Base. Good to have you on board, Corian Base and Ballymena Base, and everybody else who is watching this from wherever you are in the world. Have a good one, and we'll see you later on, guys. Okay?
Bye.
Bye-bye. 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 No idea, we dance or something?